Okay, I studied up on this, so I'm going to talk a little bit. Stop me if I say too much. Thank you for coming out. This is Jazz Combo 2, and I'm honored to direct it. And I publicly would like to thank the musicians for providing what has been a very enjoyable semester working with them, for one thing. And you got their names in the program. And we've got all kinds of solos there. We started, as you know from your program, we started off with Afternoon in Paris, which was by John Lewis. John Lewis was one of the founding members of the Modern Jazz Quartet and established what came to be known as a third stream, which was a combination of classical and jazz music in one form. And he had that bit in him. Like many jazz musicians in the 50s, he spent some time in Paris. Paris was a more welcoming environment, and Europe in general, in particular France, was a more welcoming environment for jazz musicians. So I like to think that John Lewis was enjoying all of the pleasantries of Paris when he wrote Afternoon in Paris. And then My Foolish Heart was written by Victor Young. Victor Young was a Polish classical violinist who came to the United States and wrote mostly for theater productions seemed to have absorbed American jazz harmony. And so several of the songs that he wrote are included in the jazz canon. So we've got a little bit of international theme going on here. Not too much, but Black Orpheus as well was actually written in Brazil and was originally in the film Black Orpheus, which was an international hit movie that was made in Brazil and that kind of started off the bossa nova craze in the United States for several years. Anyway, Black Orpheus.
Thank you.
This is number 393 in the book. Once in a while, I like to mess around with a standard tune. This is an old swing standby called I'll Remember April, which you may not be able to see in your program. Anyway, thank you for coming. We're going to try this with a little different twist. Thank you. musicians having a little too much fun. I said, yeah, let the ending be a little chaotic. Look what I got. Here we go. was another classical style musician from Europe, and it's another case where the jazz influence became greater in Europe than in the United States for a time. And he came and wrote, again, movie music in the United States using elements of the jazz language. And Invitation is one of those that jazz musicians then picked up and did their own version of as well. So another Polish classically trained musician who was influenced by jazz and wrote what became jazz standards for movies. An interesting twist of fate. This is Upjohn Spring. It's All American by Freddie Hubbard.
Thank you.
So what I did at the beginning of the semester is I made up a list of tunes that I felt like I hadn't played. So I'm very pleased to have been able to play some of my favorites that sometimes aren't actually popular with paying audiences. Sometimes we don't get to choose all that much what we play. So I got to choose a lot of these, and I want to thank the students for, you know, going off a little bit in the beaten path and trying out some different things. And I find it interesting that there's a couple of themes that seem to have emerged. One is that several things have been in C minor, which, you know, like maybe it's something that's in my personality that likes the minor key there. And then the other one is that there seems to be a foreign element, Polish and French. So Duke Jordan actually was another of the jazz musicians who had a better reception in their career in Europe. So he lived in Copenhagen, and he spent some time in France as well. And so as a consequence, we don't have a lot of Duke Jordan's recordings because the recording industry is in the United States. But this is one that other jazz musicians picked up, and it became more popular by other people than from his original recordings and interpretation. Anyway, Jordan. Thank you. very much.